Hello, my name is Darren Wheelock. I will be reacting to Lars Eighner's essay on dumpster diving. To do so, I will attempt dumpster diving. Unfortunately, I don't have the ability to go to a restaurant dumpster, and I'm not so sure if I would have the courage to do so. So, I will be going out and scrounging around in my apartment complex's dumpster, and I'll see what I find. All right, so I'm outside at the dumpster, and I'm sure my neighbors probably think I lost some. Let's see here. Bad lighting. A bunch of cardboard boxes. Something brand new. What is this? There's a brand new gasket set. Still in the package, thrown away. I'm seeing lots of cardboard. Some PVC and stuff. I don't know. Oh, ew. Oh, it's just condensation. Lars Eighner mentions that for the novice, everything is very suspicious for the first time. A nice Bissell sweep up. Scared the crap out of me, and it was just a broom. I see a can, and in the essay, Lars actually mentions can scroungers, people who go through dumpsters looking for cans. I'm not really interested in making 5 cents off a can, but very interesting. Some old bread by the looks of it. Very interesting. I don't think I could actually eat something out of here. However, I've often been told by people who work in restaurant and my wife who works in a pizza shop that they throw away tons of pizza. And in fact, we'll take home entire sheets of pizza left over. So Lars is definitely onto something when he talks about how much people waste and how much there is to be gained by those who need to find food by other means. So, well, that's my experience in dumpster diving. And of course, now I have to write the obligatory 300 something essay. So, thank you very much. Bye.